around 50% of all the greens, all the lentils, and all the other vegetables we feed to livestock instead that we feed it directly to humans. That'd be the lowest estimate statistics. And I think that'd be not very trustable. I think myself that actually be something like 90% of all the greens and all the other stuff on the whole world be fed to livestock. For more rational reasons. But still, if we feed that percent to all the people in poor countries, we can stop on this moment or the whole world hunger. Even one group, agriculture and technology, I have the link in the description below, acknowledge that America can feed 10 billion humans. We have only around something like 7.5 billion humans on the planet. So do the map. You don't have to be Einstein to figure out this conclusion. So blessed to me, all the stupidity of humans. I think myself that family is the downside of society. It is one of the reasons it's all happening. That people grow up listening to the doctrines of their parents, do what their family members want them to do. Not breaking that invisible umbilical cord that still exists. Not break away from their family programming. Not learn to think for themselves and think rational and compassionful. Not learn to think for themselves. I think one of the first things that humans have to learn, particularly in this age, is to learn to think for yourself. It is good to have wide open ears and listen to what anybody have to say, but when it comes to make a decision for yourself, you have to weigh anything on its own. Put out the propaganda. And learn to recognize passive-aggressive people, because they can talk very nicely, but they're actually used the whole time in manipulation. It trick people to accept their point of view, so that they don't have to change. There's a kind of manipulation technique, and so if you know, I have say. I think the kind of intelligence that humans use often, if they are, we get give that a label, whether it be actually, is manipulation. I think I find out the truth. This manipulation. Manipulation of people, manipulation of the mind, manipulation of things. A whole system exists out manipulation. People forget often how much we been that how much our system have problems with people forget often how much of our stuff come actually from nature that we use. For example, many medicines have stuff that come from nature. Many of our maples come from nature, and all the other things also come from nature. Rubber come from a rubber tree. We be not superior to our nature. We don't can make things out of nothing. And there is a limited about so-called human intelligence and human knowledge, how far it can go. And the human supremacists that say, oh, humans can still save the planet and still eat meat and that kind of shit. You being totally delusional. Because the meat industry is also the biggest cost of global warming. Around something like 51% of all the greenhouse gas emissions. This being actually smaller. I actually think that the number's been higher. Come from animal agriculture. You have to also put in consideration all the water that been used to grow the crops, because surprise, cows be not breatharians and don't live on sunlight and ether. So like some crazy humans want you to let believe. Like the human Barbie doll, that model from Russia that want to look like a Barbie doll. No, cows be not breatharians. Humans also not. We don't can photosynthesize like plants. Also, you have to in consideration all the land. We can feed.
It requires just 1/6 of an acre of land. To feed that same person on a vegetarian diet that includes eggs and dairy requires 3 times as much land. To feed an average U.S. citizen's high consumption diet of meat, dairy, and eggs requires 18 times as much land. This is because you can produce 37,000 pounds of vegetables on 1.5 acres, but only 375 pounds of meat on that same plot of land.
You have also to take in consideration that it can and take up for something like 80 pounds of greens to create 1 pound of hamburger meat. And also a lot more. I don't put on anything that you have to understand this criteria. But you can watch Cowspiracy if you want to have all the statics. You can also do your own research, but you have also to have in consideration that victimizers always to try to let their actions seem less evil and less destructive. So the lowest estimate has been most likely false. Also, you have to consider that cars produce around something like 30% of all the greenhouse gas emissions. This is actually not so hard. Do the map and you will find out it. And stop with making excuses. And for the first time, maybe I've been the first animal rights activist that asked you this question. What give you in the first place the right to take the life of another animal if it be not necessary? Plants, human beings were made for 100% herbivore, from the side to side molar, from our lower jaw, like this, to the fact that our intestinal tract is something like 7 to 12 times the length of our torso, from this point to this point. From the fact that we sweat to our pores to cool ourselves down. From the fact that we amylase in our slime to digest starch, and we don't have enzymes in our slima to digest high amount of protein. To the fact that we actually only herbivore animals can get heart attacks and strokes from eating high amounts of cholesterol rich food. Real carnivores have actually a small intestinal tract, around something like 3 to 6 times the length of their torso. They have a very short intestinal tract, so that they quickly can put rotten animal flesh and fur and other disgusting things that they eat for that glug their arteries. That's the reason that I quote. You can quote me on this. Also, only herbivore animals can get heart attacks and strokes. We're nothing happened by any real carnivore. But this is one of the biggest causes of death in the first world. Heart attack, strokes, cancer. You don't have to be answered to figure out the conclusion that humans are physiological herbivores, and that we've been the most healthiest also eating this way. And you don't have to be Einstein to figure out the conclusion how be right and how be wrong, and how be lying to you, and how speak the truth. I've been not sponsored by anybody. Also that you know that. I have no sponsors. That means that I can be honest and I can speak the truth. And that I don't been bonded on one contract. And that I have to lie to get my money. Even a lot of companies can actually support me. Because I promote a lot of vegan products. I make for a lot of them marketing. But I don't want to sponsor me, so I think they find me a little bit too how have I to say this? Real, harsh, honest. Yeah, that's not something that you can have in business. Business is political correct, lies, propaganda, slander, and put a knife between somebody else's big bones and frispering it a little bit. Bit up and down, up and down. To take all the blood of it and put it in a bucket. Business is a rotten game, actually. Business told me not about it. I've seen many of that. Been all untrustable persons. Rats. No, that's one. Harassment for rats, because rats being very decent persons. A rat don't take your money from you and a rat also don't steal from you and manipulate you in giving their stuff that they want. And rats don't take advantage of you in any way. That's only what humans do. They're always insulting other animals. And this will actually prove how much humans actually other animals hate. Because they've been so jealous of other animals. Because they've been so jealous of their cure prayers. They've been so jealous of their honesty. Humans can actually learn a lot from other animals. They can learn a lot of other animals. About decency, about honesty, about being just moral. The assumption that animals are being without morals is outdated and totally insane. All animals can choose to be kindful or not. I have a lot of videos where you can see even the most heartless carnivores giving compassion and decency to other animals. And why always try to justify your behavior with things some animals do? Actually, 75% of the animals on this planet been herbivores. They don't kill for survival. They don't murder other living beings. No. They live in harmony. They live in harmony with the planet and with its inhabitants. Seventy-five percent of all the animals being herbivores. So why we don't act like them in that way? Most of you also don't want to do some things that lions do in the wilderness. Other things than eating flesh. Most of you don't want to walk naked. Most of you don't want to have cockerels walking in your intestines, in your ears, and other insects. Most of you also don't want, I hope so, eat your own children if you don't want them. And go to a judge and say, judge, lions eat their own children. Can I justify this? Lions steal each other's prey sometimes. So can I go to some supermarket and take some food out the supermarket and take it with me? You can also say, Cross, take some other diamonds. So can I take that as one justification and can you give my that jewels? No, I have to take it. Yeah, because I find it so glimmery. No, and I mean also a lot of things that cross do well. For example, they're being very honest and real to their family members, and they don't lie, don't being selfish. The reason that lions sometimes actually they kill their own children is for so that they don't come an overpopulation. We don't come also to adjust and say, we have too much humans on this planet. that we go to kill some human. No. I've been just joking. Sorry. But that's the same kind of insanity humans used if they want to justify the consumption of animal products. They use one thing. One thing. That cherry pick one thing to justify mass murder on other living beings. What if a cow pick a chicken or an other kind of animal ever done in their whole life to deserve internal damnation, internal torture, an eternal holocaust on their behalf? Nothing. Pigs being innocent. Pigs don't murder. Pigs don't rape. Pigs don't castrate human fetuses. Fully conscious. Like humans like to do in the pig industry. They hang the animals, the baby pigs, upside down, and they rip the testicles out. And their penises. That's what I do with pigs in the concentration camp, in the pig concentration camps that we so euphemistically refer as slaughterhouses. It is disgusting and it is insane. It is obscure and it is psychopathic. Pigs be not food. No animal wants to be a victim. Actually, in the wilderness, lions give even zebras and other animals that are hunted a chance to escape. Humans don't give any times in animal chance to escape. So why use always lions do that? Lions eat meat, so why? There's always the insane mindset of the victimizer. All around whole history that people, it's humans, homo sapiens, homoide, think that give their rights about other groups. Humans have done for centuries with each other, with of their gender, of people with homosexual, with trans people. Why in God's name? Why in Odin's name? Why in Gaia's name? Why in etc. Why in Yggdrasil's name? Why in Samsara's name? There's always the mindset of the victimizer to justify errors in moral systems of humans. Why not go to the table and say any living being deserves our equal rights and freedom? We don't need it. So we free all the animals from the concentration camps that we so euphemistically refer as slaughterhouses, fur farms, leather farms. Go watch Earthlings if you want to see that. Or go if there been a fur farm and break in and free the free the minks and the foxes for me. But let you not snap, eh? Because it is a noble act, and the lack of veterinary care. Criminals don't have to get revenge on you. No, plan it correctly and without mistake. Therefore, the least expensive methods are the most appealing.
carbon monoxide
yes.
poisoning, strychnine.
It is always a justification to free beans from their oppressors.
Removed from his or her cage with a heavy neck pull. Animals walk past the rows.
There's always a justification for doing that. There's always a justification for freeing innocents from tormentors. The foxes have harmed the humans no once. So why they think that they have the right to enslave, commodified and murder them with animal electrocution in fur farms or concentration camps. So if it actually been.
And the skin carcasses seen here will later be ground up and fed to the animal still caged.
Their skin, their fur don't belong to humans. Their skin, their fur belongs to other animals. The animals were there, being born with. It is not your right. It is not your freedom. If somebody else have not. That's not somebody's right. To take somebody else's right away. To be free, to live the life the way they want. And yes, if humans once stop with commodified and torture and murder other animals, yeah, well, and there comes laws to protect cows, pigs, and other animals and squirrels from murder of humans. If that once comes one day, I will be the first one. That if I see a fox killing a rabbit, I call the cops. But until this day come, I will put the moral mirror on front of our faces. That would absolute surety. No mistake. In the meat dairy egg industry, being the most biggest massacres happening from around the whole world, around something like 60 billion land animals and around something like 90 billion marine animals being brutally executed in these places of horror and terror. Many others also in fur farms and other places of horror. In this age, we don't have to eat or murder animals for surviving. It is obscene and it is obscure. I mean, in this time, very good fake leathers that you can wear if you want to wear something that looks like leather. And there been even fake fur that pretty look like a real fur. Only if you go with your finger on the backside, you can feel it. Actually, then it feels not like skin, but like rubber. But there been ones that exactly look like that. In other ways. So don't make excuses. So stop making excuses. If you stop with making excuses, then there come a revolution. If you stop with place yourself in the position of the oppressor, stop using the victimizer's mindset. Instead that you use that mindset, you use the revolutionary mindset.